So friends, today, first let me tell you that the power which is generated and we are getting electricity at home, that uses very costly and complex equipments. Their price in market is very high. So it is our responsibility to take measures so that because of electrical hazards, say high current or a high voltage, or any other fault, short circuit or anything, those devices might not get destroyed. Otherwise, their cost of reinstallation will be very high. So for that, we need few protection devices which are placed along with the plant or various circuits whose function is to protect the device. So today we will be discussing about one of that protection device, and it is called fuse. So today my topic of discussion will be fuse. So fuse is a wire of short length or thin strip of material having low melting point. Clear? So it is a wire short length or a thin strip of metal having low melting point. So low melting point is very important. Remember that. Now the time for blowing out of fuse depends upon the magnitude of excess large current. More will be the larger the current, more rapidly will the fuse blow out. When excess current comes in, because of the I square R excess heating, the low melting point forces the fuse to melt, or blow. So this is how basically the fuse works. So let's get into the advantage of the fuse. So coming into the advantage, first is it provides cheapest type of protection. Because look, basically fuse is present everywhere you see, on every, almost every electrical board, any equipment, fuse is a must thing. So it is the cheapest type of protection that is available. Second is it needs no maintenance. That is because it is so cheap that it do not requires maintenance. Affords current limit effect under short circuit condition. Clear? So in short circuit condition, when the current's magnitude is not fixed, it can rise to any abnormally high quantity, then it acts as a current limiting factor. Interrupts enormous short circuit current without noise, flame, gas or smoke. Without noise, flame, smoke. Okay. Or any gas. So these are the advantages. Now let's move into the disadvantages, because anything that has advantage associated with it, it must be having some disadvantages also. Clear? So what are those? So talking about the disadvantage, the first disadvantage is time is lost in rewinding or replacing the fuse. Okay, so time is lost in rewinding or replacing the fuse after first operation. Clear? The second disadvantage is discrimination between fuse in series cannot be obtained unless there is a considerable distance in relative size of fuse concerned. Discrimination between fuse in series cannot be obtained unless there is considerable difference size of clear. So these are the disadvantages associated with fuse. Now let's discuss about the function of a fuse wire. Okay, so what are the function of a fuse wire? So the first function is to carry the normal working current safely without breaking. Okay. To carry the normal current okay, because look, every time breaking the circuit is not a solution. When every condition is right, every factors are what it was desired, then it is the duty of the fuse to carry that working current in the normal condition safely to the device without breaking. Clear? Now the second function is to break the circuit when current exceeds the limit current. Okay, to break the circuit when the current exceeds the limit. Okay, So that is also very important. That circuit is broken. The material used for fuse wire must be of low melting point, low ohmic loss. Characteristic, let's write down. Characteristic. Low melting point. Melting point. Low ohmic loss. High conductivity and free from deterioration. Clear? So these are the characteristics for a fuse wire. Okay, thank you.